Hello my dear friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Myself, Dattu Patel, assistant professor from LJIT. Earlier lecture, we are already discussed about the application of definite integral in first application, which is volume by a single integration. Today's session, we are going to discuss about the arc length and surface area of a revolution. Let's see. Firstly, we have to discuss length of plane curve from the in Cartesian form. The arc length of the curve y equal to f of x between x equal to a and x equal to b is given by small s indicated by the symbol of the arc length equal to integral a to b square root of 1 plus divided by dx whole square dx. Similarly, for the arc length of the curve x equal to f of y between the y equal to c and y equal to t is given by s equal to integral c to d square root of 1 plus dx by dy whole square dy. Let's see what example based on the Cartesian form. Find the arc length of the curve y equal to log sec x from x equal to 0 to x equal to pi by 3. Firstly, we have the curve which is y equal to log sec x. Then derivative of y, derivative of that curve with respect to x, that is dy by dx equal to derivative of log sec x, that is 1 upon sec x, derivative of sec x, that is sec x into tan x. Here 1 sec will be cancelled out, then it becomes tan x. Now we have to finding the arc length which is varies from 0 to pi by 2, means arc length which is indicated by the small s equal to integral 0 to pi by 3, means here integral a to b, here that is varies from 0 to pi by 3 square root of 1 plus dy by dx whole square dx. Substituting the values of dy by dx which is 10x, then integral 0 to pi by 3 square root of 1 plus 10 square x dx. 1 plus 10 square means sec square, then square root of sec square, that is sec x dx. Now integral of sec x, that is log sec x plus 10x, where x is varies from 0 to pi by 3. Substituting the limits means upper limit minus lower limit, then sec pi by 3 which is 2, 10 pi by 3 which is root 3 minus lower limit which is 0, then sec 0 which is 1 and 10 0 which is 0, then log 1 that is 0, means our answer which is log 2 plus root 3. Let's see. Next one is arc length in parametric form. Means when the equations of the curve is given in parametric form, then we have two curve x equal to f of t and y equal to g of t. Then length of arc of the curve between the two points t1 and t2 is given by arc length which is indicated by the small s equal to integral t1 to t2 square root of dx by dt whole square plus dy by dt whole square dt. Let's see one example. Find the length of curve x equal to e raised to theta sin theta by 2 plus 2 cos theta by 2 and y equal to e raised to theta cos theta by 2 minus 2 sin theta by 2. Measure the from theta equal to 0 to pi. Firstly, we have the two curve x and y. Then derivative of x with respect to theta and derivative of y with respect to theta. Firstly, we have to find it. Then substitute in formula of arc length. Here x equal to e raised to theta inside the bracket sin theta by 2 plus 2 cos theta by 2, then derivative of x with respect to theta, then dx by dt. Here this one is the u and this one is the v, then with the help of product rule, u as it is derivative of v plus v as it is derivative of u, means e raised to theta as it is derivative of sin, that is cos theta by 2 into 1 half minus derivative of cos, that is minus sine, that's why here we consider the minus, then sine theta by 2 by 1 half, 2 2 will be cancelled out, plus v term which is as it is, then sine theta by 2 plus 2 cos theta by 2 as it is, derivative e raised to theta, that is e raised to theta. Here whenever we expand the brackets, then sine theta by 2 sine theta by 2 cancel out because e raised to theta will be common out, and 1 by 2 cos theta by 2 plus 2 cos theta by 2, and taking the LCM of that term, that will give you 5 by 2 e raised to theta cos theta by 2. Similarly, derivative of y with respect to theta again we have to use product rule. U as it is, derivative of V plus V as it is, derivative of U. Means e raised to theta as it is, derivative of cos that is minus 1 half sin theta by 2 minus derivative of sin that is cos theta by 2 into 1 half, 2 will be cancel out, that will give you minus cos theta by 2 plus V term will be as it is, that is cos theta by 2 minus 2 sin theta by 2 as it is, derivative of e raised to theta that is e raised to theta. Here cos theta by 2 will be cancel out, e raised to theta will be common out and simplified that term, and that will give you minus 5 by 2 e raised to theta sin theta by 2. Now we have to finding the arc length, means for the required arc length where theta which is varies from 0 to pi, then arc length indicated by the small s equal to integral 0 to pi square root of dx by d theta whole square plus dy by d theta whole square into d theta. Substituting the values of dx by d theta and dy by d theta and squaring it, that will give you integral 0 to pi square root of 25 by 4 e raised to 2 theta cos square theta by 2 plus 25 by 4 e raised to 2 theta sin square theta by 2 d theta. Here 25 by 4 e raised to 2 theta common out, then remaining term inside the bracket cos square theta by 2 plus sin square theta by 2. Here you all are aware about the cos square theta plus sin square theta, that is the 1, that will give you integral 0 to pi square root of 25 by 4 e raised to 2 theta d theta. Now applying this square root, that will give you integral 0 to pi 5 by 2 e raised to theta d theta. Here 5 by 2 which is constant comes out, integral of e raised to theta that is e raised to theta, where theta which is varies from 0 to pi, then substituting the limits means upper limit minus lower limit, that will give you 5 by 2 e raised to pi minus 1. Let's see length of plane curve in polar form. Firstly, the arc length of the curve r equal to f of theta between the theta equal to 1 and theta equal to 2 is given by s equal to integral where limit which is varies from theta 1 to theta 2 square root of r square plus dr by theta whole square d theta. Let's see example. Find the arc length of the spiral r equal to e raised to 2 theta, where theta which is varies from 0 to 2 pi. Firstly, we have to derivative the spiral where r equal to e raised to 2 theta 2 with respect to theta. That will give you dr by d theta equal to twice e raised to 2 theta. Here, for the required arc where theta which is varies from 0 to 2 pi, then arc length which is indicated by the small s equal to integral 0 to 2 pi square root of r square plus dr by d theta whole square d theta. Substituting the values of r and dr by d theta, then integral 0 to 2 pi square root of e raised to 4 theta plus 4 e raised to 4 theta. 4 plus 1 that is 5, means integral 0 to 2 pi square root of 5 e raised to 4 theta d theta. Now square root of 5 which is constant comes out, then integral of e raised to 4 theta of square root of that term that is e raised to 2 theta, then integral of e raised to 2 theta that is e raised to 2 theta by 2, and upper limit minus lower limit, that will give you root 5 by 2 e raised to 4 pi minus 1, that is exactly arc length of the spiral. Let's see, now we have to discuss the surface area of the solid revolution. Firstly, solid revolution in the Cartesian form. The area of a surface generated by the revolving the arc of the curve about the x-axis and about the y-axis. We have the basically two kinds. Whenever our arc which is revolving about the x-axis or about the y-axis. Firstly, area of the surface generated by revolving the arc of the curve where our function in form of y equal to f of x about the x-axis is given by where arc length which is indicated by the small s and surface area which is indicated by the capital S equal to integral a to b 2 pi y square root of 1 plus dy by dx whole square dx. Similarly, about the y-axis means if whenever we revolving the about the y-axis, then our function in form of y means x equal to f of y, then surface area capital S equal to integral c to d 2 pi x square root of 1 plus dx by dy whole square dy. Whenever the about the x-axis, then here our function becomes in form of means formula which is 2 pi y, and whenever the here y-axis, then formula which is 2 pi x and dx by dy, here dy by dx. Let's see what example. Find the surface area of the revolving the generated by revolving the curve x equal to y cube from y equal to 0 to y equal to 2 about the y axis. Firstly, our equations x equal to y cube, that is the curve, then derivative of that curve with respect to y means dx by dy equal to 3y square. This is exactly shape of this curve, means y equal to x cube. Whenever we substitute the x equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on, then we get the values of y. Or substituting the values of y equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on, then we get the values of x. And plotting it, then exactly we get the such kind of shape of the equations y equal to, that is exactly shape of y, x equal to y cube. Now, we have to finding the surface area in generated by the revolving the result about the y axis, means here y which is varies from 0 to 2, and we taken the here strip, then here whenever we consider as a y equal to 2, means at that particular region we have to rotating about the y axis, means such kind of things. Then substituting this all things, means x which is replaced by y cube and dx by dy which is replaced by 3y square in our formula, that will give you surface area capital S equal to integral 0 to 2 2 pi x square root of 1 plus dx by dy whole square dy. Here x which is replaced by y cube and dx by dy, that is 3y square whole square dy. Now simplified that term, means here we cannot directly integral, then we have the formula integral function raised to n into f dash of x dx, then function raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1 plus c. Then for the making the function raised to n and derivative of its into that term, for that multiplying divide with 36, that will give you 2 pi by 36 integral 0 to 2 1 plus 9 y raised to 4 raised to 1 half into 36 y cube dy. And simplified that term, that will give you here 2 18s are, then pi by 18 1 plus 9 y raised to 4 raised to 3 by 2 by 3 by 2, where y which is varies from 0 to 2. Now substituting the limits, then upper limit minus lower limit, and simplified that term, then 18 3s are 54, denominator which is comes numerator, then 2 pi by 54, then whenever we substitute y as a 2 and simplified that term, that will give 145 raised to 3 by 2 minus 1. Now simplified that term, that will give you pi by 27 145 square root of 145 minus 1, that is exactly surface area. Now let's see another method, which is to finding the surface area of the revolution in parametric form, means when the equations of the curve is given by in form of parametric form, then we have the basically two curve, x equal to f1 of t and y equal to f2 of t, where t1 less than or equal to t less than or equal to t2. Then the surface area of the solid revolution about the x axis is given by capital S equal to integral t1 to t2 2 pi y square root of dx by dt whole square plus dy by dt whole square dt. Similarly, the surface area revolution about the y axis, here we discuss the x axis, here we discuss the y axis, is given by capital S equal to t1 to t2 2 pi x square root of dx by dt whole square plus dy by dt whole square dt. Here whenever we discuss about the x axis, then here we use the y, because our function which is 2 curve x equal to f1 of t and y equal to f2 of t, and whenever we discuss about the y axis, then here we use 2 pi x. Let's see what example. Find the surface area of the solid formed by revolving the one arc of the cycloid x equal to a inside the bracket theta minus sine theta y equal to a 1 minus cos theta about the y axis. Firstly, we have the two parametric equations x equal to a theta minus sine theta and y equal to a 1 minus cos theta. Then derivative of x and y with respect to theta, that will give you firstly dx by d theta equal to a theta has a derivative 1, sine has a derivative cos, then a inside the bracket 1 minus cos theta. And derivative of y with respect to theta, that is dy by d theta, a which is constant as it is, derivative of 1 that is 0, derivative cos that is minus sine, then minus minus plus, that will give you a sine theta. See in this graph, whenever we substitute the theta equal to 0 in equation of x and y, then here 0, sine 0 that is 0, then x equal to 0, here substitute the cos 0 that is 1, then 1 minus 1 0, then y equal to 0. Means our cycloid which is starting from 0, 0, exactly at this position. Now, whenever we substituting the theta equal to 0, pi by 2, pi by 3, pi by 4, etc. up to 2 pi, then our one cycloid and again 2 pi, that is becomes again 0, 0. Means whenever we 2 pi, sine 2 pi that is 0, then ax equal to 0, cos 2 pi that is 1, again 1 minus 1 that is 0, then y equal to again 0. Means that is our periodic form. Means this cycloid which is exactly this type of shape, again 2 pi, 4 pi, 6 pi, 8 pi and so on up to infinity. And this is about the revolving about the y axis, such kind of example. Means here theta which is varies from 0 to 2 pi and substituting the values of dx by dt, dy by d theta in our equations of the surface area. Here the area of the surface is generated by the revolving the region about the y axis, then the region of the theta which is varies from 0 to 2 pi which is shown in figure. Let's see surface area capital S equal to integral 0 to 2 pi 2 pi x square root of dx by d theta whole square plus dy by d theta whole square d theta. Substituting this value dx by d theta and dy by d theta and simplified it, then integral 0 to 2 pi 2 pi as it is, values of x that is a theta minus sine theta square root of a 1 minus cos theta whole square plus a sine theta whole square d theta. Here that is a 2 pi a constant which is comes out, integral 0 to 2 pi theta minus sine theta. In second term, a square square root of a square that is a which is comes out, then a inside the square root. Here 1 minus theta square will be expanding, then 1 minus 2 cos theta plus cos square theta plus sin square theta. Here cos square plus sin square that is 1, then 1 plus 1 that is 2. Means 2 pi a square, this a will becomes out, then 2 pi a square, integral 0 to 2 pi theta minus sin theta square root of 2 minus 2 cos theta d theta. Here root 2 will be common out, 2 will be common out, then 2 pi a square, integral 0 to 2 pi theta minus sin theta square root of 2, 1 minus cos theta d theta. Here with the help of trigonometric formula, means 1 minus cos theta equal to 2 sin square theta by 2, here 2 into 2 that is 4. Then applying the trigonometric formula, because here we cannot integral u v rule, because both the function u and v both are trigonometric form, then we cannot apply the Bernoulli's equation as well as u v rule or a integrating by parts method. For that we need to some simplification. For that 2 pi a square, integral 0 to 2 pi theta minus sin theta, here applying the trigonometric formula, that will give you square root of 4 sin square theta by 2 d theta. Yes, square root of 4 that is 2, then 2 will becomes out, then 2 into 2 which is 4 pi a square, integral 0 to 2 pi theta minus sin theta into theta by 2 d theta. Here expanding the brackets, means sin theta by 2 comes inside the brackets, means we get the theta into sin theta by 2. Here sin theta into sin theta by 2, but you all are aware about the formulas of sin theta, that is 2 sin theta by 2 into cos theta by 2, then 2 sin theta by 2 into, means sin square theta by 2 into cos theta by 2, that will give you 4 pi a square, integral 0 to 2 pi theta sin theta by 2 minus 2 sin square theta by 2 into cos theta by 2 d theta. Here we have to apply the u v rule, means in first term that is the values of u, second term is v, means apply the Bernoulli's equation or integrating by parts in a continuum manner, that is a u integration of u v rule. In second term we apply the function raised to n into f dash of x, then we get function raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1. Now in first term 4 pi a square which is constant comes out, u as it is, integral of v that is minus cos theta by 2 upon 1 half, derivative of theta that is 1, integration of that term that is minus sin theta by 2 upon 1 by 4. Now derivative of 1 that is 0, then 0 into anything 0, then remaining all the terms are 0, where theta, which is varies from 0 to 2 pi, minus here we apply the function raised to n into f dash of x, then function raised to n plus 1 upon n plus 1, then minus sine as it is, this one is minus cap as it is, 2 sine cube theta by 2 upon 3 by 2, where theta which is varies from 0 to 2 pi. Now substituting the limits means applying the upper limit minus lower limit, 4 pi a square as it is inside the bracket, here we replace theta as a 2 pi, then theta, then 2 pi, this 2 will become numerator portion, then 2 into 2, 4 pi, here we replace as 2 pi, 2 will be cancel out, then cos pi will be minus 1, then minus minus plus 1, then 4 pi into 1, that is 1, minus minus plus, here 2 pi, then 2 will be cancel out, then sin pi, values of sin pi, that is 0, then 0 into anything, 0, minus lower limit, then theta into theta as a replace as a 0, then 0 into anything, 0, sin 0, that is 0, means this lower limit will be 0, minus this term, sin 2 pi, 2 2 will be cancelled out, sin pi, that is 0, 0 into anything, 0, minus sin 0, that is also 0, here this term, upper limit and lower limit both are 0, then only we get the first term, that is 4 pi, then expand this term, that will give you 4 4s are 16, then 16 pi square a square, that is exactly surface area. Let's see area of the surface of the solid revolution in the polar form. For the curve r equal to f of theta bounded between the radius vector where theta equal to 1 2 theta equal to theta 2, the area of the surface of the solid revolution about the initial line where this one is our initial line theta equal to 0, this line indicated by the our initial line where surface area capital S equal to integral theta 1 to theta 2 2 pi r sin theta square root of r square plus dr by theta whole square d theta. Similarly for the theta equal to pi by 2 line, then the area of the surface of the solid of the revolution about the theta equal to pi by 2 line is given by capital S equal to where integral theta 1 to theta 2 2 pi r cos theta square root of r square plus dr by d theta whole square d theta. Let's see one example. Find the surface area of the curve r equal to e raised to theta by 2 is revolved about the initial line. Initial line means theta equal to 0 line between the theta equal to 0 to theta equal to pi. Here firstly we have the r equal to e raised to theta by 2, then derivative of r, that is with respect to theta, means dr by d theta equal to 1 by 2 e raised to theta by 2. Now here our theta which is varies from 0 to pi, then surface area capital S equal to integral 0 to pi 2 pi r sin theta square root of r square plus dr by d theta whole square d theta. Substituting the values of r and dr by d theta in this equation and simplified it, that integral 0 to pi 2 pi r which is replaced as a e raised to theta by 2 and sin theta kept as it is, square root of e raised to theta by 2 whole square, that is e raised to theta 1 by 2 e raised to theta by 2 whole square, that is 1 by 4 e raised to theta d theta. In this term, simplified that term, that will give you square root of 5 by 4 e raised to theta d theta. Here our function which is in form of theta, then integral with respect to theta, then firstly we have to simplify that term. Here square root of 4, that is 2, and 2 2 will be cancel out, means simplified that term, that will give you integral 0 to pi, here 2 2 will be cancel out, then here pi will be constant which is comes out, then pi into root 5 integral 0 to pi e raised to theta by 2, here also e raised to theta by 2, that is e raised to theta into sin theta d theta. Here we cannot apply the integration of UV rule or integral of product rule, means here we have the formula e raised to ax into sin bx dx equal to e raised to ax upon a square plus b square a sin bx minus b cos bx. In this equation, substituting the values of a equal to 1 and b equal to 1, means whatever the coefficient which is multiplied with theta, then e raised to a theta, then a equal to 1 sin b theta, means theta has a coefficient 1, then substituting the values of a and b in this equation, then pi into root 5 inside the bracket e raised to theta upon 1 square plus 1 square, that is 2, inside the bracket a sin theta minus b cos theta, means values of a and b are 1, then sin theta minus cos theta, where theta which is running from 0 to pi, then substituting the limits, upper limit minus lower limit, then pi root 5 inside the bracket, theta replaced as a pi, then e raised to pi by 2, values of sin pi that is 0, values of cos pi that is minus 1, then minus minus plus 1, minus e raised to 0 that is 1, then 1 half, sin 0 that is 0, cos 0 that is 1, then 0 minus 1. Expanding this term and simplified this, that will give you pi root 5 by 2 inside the bracket e raised to pi plus 1. These all are the practice example which is try yourself. This is all about the topics of the arc length and the surface area of the revolution. I hope you guys you learn something from this video. If you like this video, then thumbs up. If you think that this video will help some of your friends, then do the share with them. If you want to watch more tutorial like this, then you can subscribe my YouTube channel, and whenever I upload the new video, you get the notification. If you have any query regarding this, then feel free contact me. Thank you so much for watching me.